We're very pleased to be joined today by Liberia's Assistant Minister of Education for Basic and Secondary Education, the Honourable Tokunboh E. Lawrence, and also by the World Food Programme's Country Director for Liberia, Madame Adama Diop-Faye. And without further ado, can I introduce firstly Minister of Education for Basic and Secondary Education, the Honourable Tokunboh E. Lawrence.
We now have the first national school feeding policy in the history of Liberia, which will be launched tomorrow at the City Hall. And this is very important. The school feeding in Liberia started, initially in 1968, way in the late 60s. Where we had a lot of care food by the U.S., Agriculture Department. And in the 70s, we had a World Food Program on board. And since then, we have been doing school feeding in collaboration with other partners. But we have come to the place now that we are going to expand the food feeding. And with the decentralization policy, we want to get everybody involved in the country. All our stakeholders, which include, it's not only government ministries and agencies. We have the, of course, education. We have Ministry of Agriculture, Ministry of Health, Ministry of Justice, and Ministry of Internal Affairs. We also have World Food Programs. We also have other partners like the Mary's Meal, and we also have the IRD, International Relief for Development, which World Food Program now is in like 13 counties, and we have IRD in like 2 counties and Mary's Meal in 2 counties. So this is a good program today because we're gonna get also, we have our communities and our PTA, and all these partners are gonna come together after the launching. They are already operating, but we have one uniform policy. And so the collaboration is very important, and I'm glad that we are here today to get as much information to the public.
You know, the school feeding program has been on for quite a while with the support of WFP, but having a policy now means a lot to the country and to all the actors in the field of school feeding, because it paves the way to a framework actually that will help harmonize our interventions. It will also show to donors how much school feeding is important for the government of Liberia. And in the school feeding policy, you will see that there is a lot of guidance, the roles of all the actors, starting from people in the Ministry of Health, passing through all the actors and all the other ministries also, because you would wonder what the Minister of Health is doing into a school feeding policy. But before starting a school feeding program in a school, there are some conditions that need to be fulfilled by that school, like ensuring that we have safe drinking water in the school, that children have a deworming program. They are provided with deworming tablets. The school has access as latrines also, because all water and sanitation facilities need to be in a school, and most of the time they are provided by the Ministry of Health and all the supporting ministries. We are also trying to develop capacity in agriculture by opening some school gardens in schools, not only to supplement the food that we are providing and help the diet to be diversified, but at the same time to grow some interest into children in agriculture, because we know that not many people are involved into the agriculture sector, and the food production is only 30% of the food requirement in this country. So we want at the childhood level already to grow some interest into gardening by helping and teaching to children, school children, how to grow food. And at the same time, we are supplementing with the vegetables that they are growing to the diet of the school feeding program.